Hello, everyone. Thanks for joining us today. Today we are going to look at the various ways to use Navisworks while leveraging the cloud. Whenever you're talking about anything Autodesk and the cloud means BIM 360. Although I've mentioned that, we won't be looking at BIM 360 from the ground up. However, we will be focusing on the model coordination service and comparing that to the classic Glue service, as well as Navisworks in the local environment. Here's what we're going to talk about today. First, we'll look at how model coordination works in BIM 360. I went ahead and uploaded some files to save time so that we can go right into it. You're going to see that when using model coordination in the BIM 360 environment, it's pretty much automatic. Second, we'll take a quick look at the classic version of coordination in BIM 360, which is called BIM 360 Glue Classic, and it's still available. Many of the original features of Navisworks were implemented here. Third, we'll look at coordination from inside Navisworks. We're going to do that with one model that's stored in the cloud and one that's stored locally. And lastly, we'll look at an alternative way to review an aggregated model for the situation where BIM 360 is not available. Before we get started here, I want to point out that I will be working with files that did not come from Revit. It seems that we always see demos or tutorials that are using only Revit files as the samples, so I decided to do something different here. In case any of you are interested in leveraging BIM 360 and you use other design tools, in this case, the models are coming from Advanced Steel and Plant 3D. Let's get started. Okay, so here's the home page of our project in BIM 360. It's already set up. We've turned a couple of services on, and we're just going to get the lay of the land before we get started here. So I'm going to go to Project Admin just for a moment and over to Services. And I just want to point out what we have turned on here. Usually the first service we turn on when we set up a project in BIM 360 is Document Management. We need that enabled so that we can upload our files for all our projects. I've also turned on Design Collaboration simply because I did mention I'm using a file from Plant 3D. That project is using the new collaboration service, which is available in 2021. So I went ahead and turned that on. You'll need that as well if you're using Revit or Civil 3D. And then we have the model coordination service turned on, and that is one we're going to focus on here. Over in Document Management, I mentioned that I went ahead and uploaded my files. And I just didn't want you all to have to sit here and wait for files to process while they're being uploaded. So I've done that. This right here is the project that came from Plant 3D. That's covered during our training that we do for that, as well as in an upcoming webcast that I'll do for you. Now for model coordination, that is all done under the plans area of Document Management. So I've got some files uploaded here. And I also went ahead and uploaded my additional files to take care of the change that I'm going to simulate once we start doing clash detection. So the folder in question right now is this first one here. I've got my two files loaded already, and we're going to set up a coordination space here in just a moment. These other two folders are just for my use today so that I can swap those files in very quickly and prevent you having to watch me upload them. All right. Now, I've got the files already loaded into the coordination folder here. And when I'm ready to coordinate, I'm going to go to Project Admin and set up a coordination space. So in Project Admin, you'll go to Services, and as long as that service is turned on, we'll go to Model Coordination on the left side of the screen. And then we'll create a new coordination space. And all we do to get this going is we give it a name, and then we pick the coordination folder that we want to run against that. That's the folder there. Once you create that folder, models get merged, and the clashes will be sitting there waiting for you. So there's nothing else we need to do in order to look for clashes. So once we set up the space, then we'll switch to model coordination. And once you do that, those models will then be brought on screen, merged, and the clash results will be calculated. Now, I may have to refresh my screen here. Sometimes this takes a moment, but if you do that, then it kind of pushes it forward and allows it to proceed. There we go. All right, so there's the two models that are in the folder from the plans area. They're ready to view. I could select these models here and go to the view tool and look around. I prefer to go right to the clashes and do it from there. So there's a clash with our two models. Now, if you have more models in your project, which is very possible, this grid will be a lot more involved. You'll have a lot more cells and things like that. So in this case, I do have these models set up so that they just have one clash for us to focus on and not so overwhelming. So I'm going to select one of the cells here and focus in on that clash. And we'll be able to see very quickly where that clash is located. Now, once your view comes up, I could orbit and look around. What I'm going to do over here on the left in the clashes bar is just select on that clash that's listed, and then we'll be able to see it a little more quickly. So I could use the basic viewing tools, the view cubes available to you, just like when you're inside any of the Autodesk products. But now that we can see it, I know it's a clash. I can go ahead and deal with that. Now to do that, your project manager, your reviewer, or whoever is tasked with this effort here, what they'll do is they'll select the checkbox for that clash or the number of clashes if you have more than one, and then start an issue for that. Now here's where you want to zoom in. That way you can select in the vicinity of that area, and that will apply focus to this view and take people right to this spot when they look at this issue. That will also open up the description, the title, and the date and who you're assigning it to so you can make changes. Here, I'll just add a little note. Something like that. We'll assign it, give it a date. I'll pretend I'm being a little impatient here, so I'll pick today and then create it. Now, I do have properties available to me, so to find out what size that pipe is, so we know how big that hole might be. We can select the pipe. We can come down to the tools at the bottom of the screen, activate the properties, and then from here, find out what size pipe that is. That way, we can communicate that to the designer, and they know how big to cut that hole in the conflicting element there. All right, so once that's created, we'll close the viewer, and you'll notice that it looks like in the clash environment here that there is no more clash, and that's because it has moved downstream. You'll see it on the assigned tab now versus active. So it's not like you lost your class, it's just been progressed. From here, the next person, whoever it's assigned to, they'll get their email, and they can then come to this exact page. They can look at the issue the way you set it up for them. So we'll do that next. All right, so there it is. There is going to be focus on that. So there's our clash. So it's taken me right to it. I can see the notes down here. And at this point, I would go back into advanced steel in this case, add the cutout for that piece of pipe there, upload the model to the coordination space again. Now that would bump the version of that file, and then advance that clash and close it. Now to simulate that, I don't need to open advanced steel today. I've got that other file sitting in one of my backup folders just to save time. So I am going to switch over to document management. Now this is just for today. In a design environment, I'd be going back to the software to make that change and then re-upload. Here, I'll just go to the folder that I have set up. I just need to wait for my browser here. There we go. And we'll come into this folder here. And all I'm going to do is copy this file from this folder over to my coordination folder. It's the only reason I have that file sitting there today. But it will bump the version. And now I can see that my structure file is now a version 2. There's the issue. So BIM 360 is still keeping track. It knows that file's been updated. It knows we still have an issue to deal with. So at this point, we're just pretending I went to advanced steel, made the change, did the upload. Now I can go over to the issues tab in document management. And there's the issue. I'll select on the link document, which is right here. Once that loads, the issue will appear on the left. Now I'm focused in on that. And now I can provide a response to this issue, which will notify the approver and then go ahead and get that issue closed. So I'm going to do answered on this issue. I'll give an answer. Something like that. Now once we do that, the next person in sequence would get notified, which means they would come to issues here, or they may just go to project home. So this could be the project manager, whoever signs off on clashes and things like that for that project. Notice here that now the project issue, it can be sitting on the home page for that project in BIM 360. Its color has changed. It was orange before. That means it's open and it needs action. Now it's blue, which means it's been answered by someone. And if I'm the approver now, I can see what's been done up to this point. I can go to additional details. That will take us back into the issue. And then we can see the additional notes. Those will actually be under activity. So when I did the answer a moment ago, you'll see that under activity. And there's the note that I just added when I answered it. As the approver, I can use the drop down here and close it. That will remove it from the home page. And those that are supposed to be notified, that will happen at this point through email. All right, at this point, we could go back into model coordination and look around, but that clash has been taken care of. But if anyone wants to see it, they would just circle back. They could come into that coordination space that was set up. They could merely view the models, and they'll be able to clearly see that the hole's been added. You could also go to the clashes and notice that there will be no clashes because it's all automatic. You could run another clash test if you want, meaning you'd set up another coordination space if you wanted to, but it's not necessary to do that. But there's nothing stopping you from doing that. All right, so that's one way to use the next gen model coordination. It's all done inside BIM 360. Everything is centralized there once you have your files uploaded. Now, the next example I want to do is similar, except we're going to look at BIM 360 Glue Classic. Now, the only difference here is going to be which service is turned on in the project. I went ahead and did that in a separate project. The files are the same. The setup is the same, except for that one setting for the coordination service. So if we go over to Project Admin on a project like this, that's using the classic version of coordination, when you go to services, you'll see BIM 360 Glue under services instead of model coordination. And that's the difference. So when you turn on coordination in a project, you'll be faced with a choice and you'll choose the new one or the classic one, and that sets it up. Now, keep in mind that once you turn this service on, it is baked into the project and you won't be able to change it. So keep that in mind. It won't hurt you, but it is a one-way trip. So BIM 360 Glue is now active, which means we don't need to use, or we won't be able to use, document management for our files. So we won't go to the coordination folder or the plans folder there. What we have to do at this point is use the desktop software for BIM 360 Glue. That is still available. And it looks like this. Now, once your project is set up on BIM 360, you'll see it in the desktop application. And you'll go here instead of straight to BIM 360 to do your coordination. So there's the project. I'll go ahead and open that up. Again, to save time, I've uploaded the models that I want to coordinate. So here's the difference, that fork in the road. You'll come here to upload the files versus go to document management and upload them into the plans area. Since I've already uploaded these, all I need to do is merge them and start the clash detection. So I'll do a new merged model here. And we'll select these two models here. Make sure we get the one that has the clash in it. Give it a name. Now, this is very similar to operating in Navisworks when you append models together and then save them as an NWF file. The difference here is there is no physical NWF file. It's just called a merged model that sits in the Glue application. So just got to make sure we give it a name and then we merge the models. Now, this does look a lot like Navisworks out in the viewing area. The difference is you don't have the ribbon. The rest of the interface looks quite different. We'll go on over here to the clashes tab on the left and find clashes. So here's the difference between the next gen and classic. In Classic, we have to tell it to find the clashes, which models we want to clash, or which elements we want to clash. This right here is very similar in its behavior to the clash detective in Navisworks. So we still have to pick our models. If you need a tolerance, you'll add that right here. This is another difference. I've noticed that if I leave the tolerance set to zero here, then anything that is face-to-face will be treated like a clash. So to make sure that I only get real actual clashes here, I'm going to add a little bit of tolerance, just enough so it doesn't include face-to-face type situations. Give it a name and then find the clashes. That step right there is automatic in the next-gen model coordination. So there's our clash, the glue way. We'll select it. We still get our focus on that. Now I can mark this up. I can comment it, and I can email that to the person that needs to take care of that issue. Another difference in Glue Classic, there is no issues interface like there is in the next gen product. So there's the markup tools. They behave the same as they do in next gen. The interface just looks a little different. So I could mark this up. I can add some text there if I want. There's a comment box here, so I could still do a lot of the same things, but there's just no back-end automation to notify your team members to take care of these. You have to click a button in order to send that email to someone so they know what to do. So I'll go ahead and save that. Last step would be to email that, and then you pick your team member and so forth. All of this is automated in Next Gen. So there's a sample of a clash in Classic. Again, to address it, since I already have those files uploaded, I can do a simple swap. In a live environment, this would just get uploaded again to Glue Classic. In this case, what I'm going to do is go back into that merged model and go to the Models tab on the left. I'm just going to remove the structure model from that space there. And then I'm going to add my other model to it. Once you do that, in Glue Classic, when you go back to the Clashes tab, there's my clash, or the test that we just set up. Since the models have been updated, you'll get a notice. Now I can just update the results to view the changes. And now you'll see that that clash is gone. So that's one way in Classic that we can address clashes and quickly rerun those tests without having to set up a new one. So I think that is one advantage of the Classic interface. It's very quick in updating existing clash tests, and you don't have to set up new ones. And that is M360 Glue Classic. Remember, this is a separate install that has to be done, and it runs as separate software, just like Navisworks or anything else. All right, now let's look at a similar example, but we'll do this one from Navisworks. Now, remember I said in the beginning that we'll do this as a mixture of cloud files and local files. Now, if your files are loaded into BIM 360, someone with Navisworks can use the BIM 360 Glue plugin that is installed with Navisworks now. You'll go to the project dropdown, and you'll select that project. As long as you've been invited to it by the project admin, it'll be on this screen right here. So I'm going to choose next. There's the merged model we were looking at a moment ago. Here are the three models that were loaded into Glue Classic. So I could create my own merged model from inside Navisworks. I could do that. It'll be stored in Glue. Since there's already one here, I'll just open it. And it'll bring those files in here for me. Now, I won't do an actual clash test here, but if I did, this could be done from inside Navisworks. I could use the clash detective, add the test, and this is the same thing as doing a find clashes in Glue Classic. However, the difference is anything you do in the clash detective in Navisworks, you'll only see that test in Navisworks. That's the one caveat here. If you're using Navisworks and your files are in BIM 360, the clash detective stays here, and vice versa. Anything you do in Glue Classic, you'll only see those tests when you're running that software. So keep that in mind. If you want this to be shareable with the rest of a BIM 360 project, then you'll want to use the Glue Classic software to run those clash tests. And that's really the only difference there between the two. So a lot of similarities between Navisworks and BIM 360 Glue Classic. That's one of the big differences, though. Now, I'm going to start another, or just clear this out. If I wanted to create my own merged model from within Navisworks, I could do that. I could go to Append. And once I do that, there's the BIM 360 project that I've been invited to. Down at the bottom of the screen, though, you can append a local model. So let's do that. If I'm working outside of BIM 360 Glue, no problem. I can just go and get the files the way I normally would, off of the company server or off of my computer. So I'll go completely outside of BIM 360. Load up a file. And if I wanted to get one from BIM 360, but I didn't go through the tab that's in Navisworks, and I still did an append, I could still get to those files if I have the Autodesk desktop connector installed. So in Windows, if you happen to see BIM 360, that means you do have the BIM 360, or excuse me, the desktop connector. We could still get it from there. This will take you into the project files. This is that Plant 3D project that I told you about. It's already been collaborated. I'll go into the folder that contains that model and open it. So it's very similar to loading a local model. I just happen to do it with a cloud model here. Now, once I save this file, it will want to save an NWF because I started by appending local models. So you actually have a little flexibility here if you are more comfortable with Navisworks than you are with Glue Classic. Again, I'll be resorting to the Clash Detective, but it will be contained inside the local file versus shared through BIM 360. Now, let's pretend you're a user who doesn't have access to BIM 360 at all. This is our last example. What do we do then if we still need to share somewhat with the outside team members? We would set up using a traditional append methods in Navisworks. And what you'll want to do is save yourself an NWD file. And it doesn't matter where your models come from once you're inside Navisworks. So we'll save that as an NWD. I'll just save it on my desktop for the time being. I do recommend that you save it as the later version of NWD. Now, if you do have some folks on your project, if they're using older releases of software, maybe you'll save it as Navisworks 2015. But if you can avoid it, save it as the latest, which would be that one. We'll go ahead and save that file. Now, in order to share it, what you'll want to do is use the free Autodesk Viewer to share this with your team. This will be completely outside of BIM 360. Again, to save time here, I've already uploaded this file, which we would do right here. And there it is. Now, once these files are uploaded, then we can share them with a link, and then those folks can access the viewer just like you would. And it still looks like Navisworks out in the viewing area, and you still have access to a lot of the same tools. We've got our markup tools down here. So I can mark this up and save it, add text, etc. There's a comment panel. So comments are going to be tracked. So everything that everybody does can still be centralized, but it is in a view format. We've got properties here, so we can still access all of the same properties that you have access to in Navisworks or in BIM 360. We also have the model browser. The difference is you don't have clash detection up here in the viewer. It's strictly view only and markup only. And these files have a expiration date on them. So if I back out of the view here and just go back to the main screen, there is an expiration on those. So these files are meant to be temporary. So if you're concerned about security or intellectual data, then they do have a shelf life. And once it's gone, it's gone. And we don't have access to it. And the only way that you can provide access to one of these files is by sharing the link for those files. Now, these are extendable, so if you need to leave one available for a longer period, you can do that. However, we don't have clash detection in here. Even if you run a clash test in Navisworks, it's saved in the NWD, but someone on the other end has to be able to open the NWD with Navisworks Manage in order to view that clash. So that one piece is only available online through BIM 360 or Glue Classic. In either case, you'd be subscribing to BIM 360. So that is a difference there, but there are alternatives in case you're the type of user who doesn't have access to BIM 360. So let's review. First, we did the next gen model coordination. In here, the services that you'll want to enable are going to be document management, design collaboration, if you're doing work in Revit, Civil 3D, or Plant 3D, you'll need that service, and model coordination. But be careful here. You have to choose either model coordination, which is the next gen, or BIM 360 Glue Classic. Once you make this choice and click the finish button, you can't change it. This won't hurt you, but it will affect how the team will be doing clash detection. If you choose the classic method here, make sure to install the desktop version of BIM 360 Glue, because you'll be performing your coordination from there instead of directly in BIM 360 via your web browser. Now, once the service is set up and you're using the next gen, you'll create a subfolder underneath the plans folder in document management. That's where model coordination will look for the files. If the files are already in BIM 360 under the projects folder and you need one of those to coordinate, you can upload it via the desktop connector. You'll also need to create a coordination space. That can be done from Project Admin, or if it's the first one that you're setting up, you can go straight to Model Coordination, and then it will take you over to create it. So BIM 360 will know what to do in that case. Now, it doesn't matter what order you do those two things in, set up the space and upload your files, as long as you do both. Once they're both done, you'll go to model coordination, and BIM 360 will merge the models automatically and then calculate the clashes. In the second example, we looked at the classic glue method. You'll need the same three services turned on in your project. And when you select model coordination, make sure you choose BIM 360 Glue Classic instead, and then make sure that you install the classic desktop application, and all your coordination will be done from there. In the desktop application, you'll upload the models that you would like to coordinate. Just keep in mind that Glue Classic is a separate platform from Next Gen, so you won't see these files under document management in BIM 360. However, all the folks that have permission to the project and to those files will be able to access them through Classic Desktop. And then lastly, you'll create the clash tests in the desktop software. The third example, we looked at cloud coordination from Navisworks. You can set this up with files that have been uploaded via BIM360 Glue Desktop or with files that are stored locally. When using cloud files in Navisworks, make sure you use the BIM360 Glue tab in the ribbon. When you save the aggregated model, you'll have the option to save it as a merged model in Glue Classic, or you can save it locally as an NWF file. The one caveat here is that if you use the clash detective in Navisworks, the clash test will be stored in the file, but it will not be visible in the cloud. So the only place you'll see those will be inside Navisworks. The same goes for clash tests that you create in the Glue Classic application. You will not see them in Navisworks. In the last example, we looked at using Navisworks without BIM 360 and instead used the free viewer from Autodesk. You can still share with anyone by providing a link to the file that you upload. NWD file is probably the best format to do this with. You'll still have access to the markup tools, properties, comments, and the model browser. You can also take measurements, but there are some restrictions. There is no clash feature, and it is view only. And for the sake of security, files expire after 30 days, but you can extend that if needed. Here are resources that Hagerman has that you can take advantage of for self-help. On our YouTube page, you'll find the recordings for all our previous webcasts. This one will be available shortly. Plus, we have plenty of articles on our blog at hagerman.com and even more content on our customer hub. And as always, you can contact us directly for support.